Hello, ladies and gentlemen. This is a 2012 Ford Edge. How do we remove the master brake cylinder? First of all, you gotta remove the battery. After you remove the battery, then you take the battery seat out. After you remove the battery seat out, and then you can go ahead and disconnect the line that goes connected to the brake booster. And then you can unplug that plug right here that attaches the reservoir for the brake fluid. Then you remove the first line. After that, you can remove the second line. And then to remove the master brake cylinder, you got one screws right here that you're looking at. This one right here, you got that one with the socket 13 millimeter, and you got that one right there. This one. Alright, with the socket 13 millimeter. And you can also put an extension on it right here. This is what I do. And also, I use my battery ratchet right here on the floor. This is the old master. I had removed the bushing in there because this is where the brake line goes. I have removed the bushing in there. I think that the new one doesn't come with it, but it does. Which is right here. That's the bushing. Alright, so before you install the master brake cylinder, you can go ahead and put brake fluid in there. Remove the old brake fluid and put the new brake fluid in there. And then you can bleed it before you install it. Because if you don't bleed it, you're going to have more work to do. And you might end up destroying the new brake or master brake cylinder if you don't bleed it. Okay, so what I mean by bleed it, you can go ahead and get the new master cylinder when it come like this. It come like this. This is where the brake line goes. So you're going to see those in there. You're going to see those bushing in there. So it come like this. When you go ahead on the side of the master brake cylinder, where the reservoir goes. The reservoir goes right here on the top. And on the side is here, there's a screws that screws right here. And to you have to unscrew that one so you can, in order for you to remove the brake fluid reservoir out. And after you do that, you install it in the new one. You put brake fluid in the reservoir, like I did right here. You put brake fluid in there, and then before you install it back in the vehicle, you some people do it manually. Some people have the machine to bleed it. Where I do it manually, where I put the brake fluid in there, and I have these little things, the screws that come with it. Okay, and put tube in it, and then you bleed it one at a time. Okay, it's two of them. Here you go the other one right here. Okay, you bleed one at a time. So this one right here, this is for the front, this one for the back. And these two lines go ahead and screw them in ABS module. That's the module right here. Okay, that you're looking at in the bottom. So I'm gonna, after I did that, I still have to bleed all the tires, so I have to do the front one first, then do the back. And and the front tires, there's in the caliper, you see that, you're looking at the little thing pointing. That's what I'm gonna have to use, a socket 10 or wrench 10, and turn the tires on my left side. When you stand in front of the car, it's gonna be on your right side. You gotta bleed it from there. Okay, as well as in the passenger side and the back side too. Alright, so this is a basic how to deal with the master brake cylinder. You can like my video, subscribe. I always got video, I'm uploading new videos coming. Thanks for watching. And if you have a question, you can go ahead and post it on. If I didn't get a chance to see it, I'm sure somebody will watch my video and have knowledge as well, will reply to your question. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe. Emmanuel.